Michelle's secret speech bashed Trump and his voters, so Melania gave her a nasty surprise. Michelle Obama has been on the media circuit over the last 2 months, appearing at different venues and giving keynote speeches. However, one local reporter did take note of her talk to the sold-out Bushnell Center in Connecticut. Michelle insinuated that we are in troubled times, referring to the presidency of Donald Trump. She also made thinly veiled remarks about his supporters, and she wasn't going high. Well, Melania Trump had a response, and it is a nasty surprise. Michelle Obama is raking in $200,000 to $400,000 per speech, and she has strict guidelines, namely, no media. We wondered why she would not want the press hanging on her every word, and now, we may know the reason. Thursday, she gave the keynote address at the Bushnell Center in Hartford, Connecticut. One local reporter must have taken notes because the liberal-leaning Huffington Post's article tells us it was all about Donald Trump's presidency. The Huffington Post reports, if you're like most humans, the current political climate has caused you some excess anxiety or tension. Recent research shows that the majority of Americans are stressed about the future of the nation and even relationships with loved ones are feeling the strain. Michelle Obama is here to offer some guidance on how to deal with it all, and her advice is pretty spot on. So, what is the current political climate supposed to mean? Well, to the Obamas and the Democratic Party, it's a living hell as they whine about Trump 24/7. The arrogance is Michelle Obama assuming the entire country is suffering since Trump was elected. 10 months after leaving the White House, Michelle Obama offered advice on how to live in the Trump era to a packed house at the Bushnell Center for the Performing Arts, reports the Hartford Courant, adding, the former First Lady never mentioned President Donald Trump by name during her 75-minute talk Thursday night, but she laid out her strategy for coping in tumultuous times. Oh, don't you just love the passive-aggressive nature of these liberal losers? Michelle's coping mechanisms, that she took 75 minutes to explain, are only needed if you view the country as out of control and on the wrong road since Trump was elected. Michelle didn't have to mention the president by name or any of us who support him. We know that in their eyes, we are the deplorables and we stress them out. Michelle's tips included, focus on what you can control. Be a good person every day. Vote. Read. Treat one another kindly. Follow the law. Don't tweet nasty stuff, reports the Hartford Courant. Michelle gave it her best to make women hate Trump at the Democratic Convention, where she focused on the bogus sexual harassment accusations against the president by women who were later discredited. She also focused on his private conversation with Billy Bush, known as the Access Hollywood tape. Michelle's a hypocrite, and this tweet proves it. Where is her condemnation of a real sexual predator, Senator Al Franken? She's a leader of the Democratic Party, so where is her call for him to resign immediately? Now, let's take a look at the woman who is currently in power as the First Lady, Melania Trump. She was straight up asked while in China about her first year in the White House, as the CNN reporter said, has there been anything frustrating or surprising for you? She could have mentioned the attacks from the press, and she could have mentioned how the Democrats lie about her and her husband's relationship. But no, she actually goes high, when Michelle is raking in cash going low, bashing the Trumps. Well, it's my honor to be a First Lady of the United States, and it was a very busy year, said Melania, smiling as she recounted what life is like now. We love to live in Washington, we have a very busy life. It's exciting, as well, she said. It's a lot of things that we need to take care of, and a lot of responsibilities, said Mrs. Trump, and it's all part of being the First Lady. How's that as a nasty surprise? Michelle is all talk about not tweeting nasty things, yet she is shutting out the media so the majority of Americans won't hear her Trump bashing. She could take a lesson from Melania Trump. Michelle divides the country while Melania's answers are positive for the whole country, whether you voted for her husband or not. Melania brings us all together, something Michelle was never interested in doing.